Hello guys, in our previous video we were able to install Python in Windows, and now we are going to look at how we can install the Virtualenv, how we can manage virtual environments using Python in Windows. So we have opened our terminal, and we can, as a start, we can confirm that pip is installed by typing the pip-v, and we see that it is installed and the version number and where it is installed. So we can also type pip help to show the commands or the help information for using pip, and it gives us this array of information or array of commands that you can use with pip. So it's a very powerful tool, and we are going to use it in this video. So we can also list the packages that have been installed. By default, when you install Python and pip in Windows, it has pip and setup tools as the only packages that have been installed. So we will ignore this warning for now, for that it's telling us to update the pip version. In our next command, we will install the, we will first of all clear our terminal, and then we will install the Virtualenv package, and we note that we are installing it globally. As a standard practice, it is always good to, when you're working with projects in Python, you install them in a virtual environment specific to that project. So we have been able to install the Virtualenv and its package and its dependencies, and we can clear the terminal. Then we type pip list, which will list the packages. So you'll notice that we have additional packages which were not there before. We only had two. So this is what happens when you install the packages globally. They continue to populate the global Python, the global list of pip. And in this case, you may find that you're going to bloat your computer. You may have issues with dependency management. So we have navigated into our desktop in the terminal, and we are going to create a new directory using the mkdir command, and we'll make create a directory called test folder. And you'll notice in my desktop on the left, it has created the folder. So we are going to run the command to create a virtual environment, and we will use Python, the dash m switch, and then pip Virtualenv and the name of the virtual environment that you want to create. So we first move navigate into the folder, our test folder we are using, and then you can type the command. So this command creates a virtual environment, a new virtual environment inside the folder, our test folder. And the virtual environment will be called venv or the venv. So this is what also the PyCharm does when you create a new project. So we have confirmed that it has indeed created a folder that is called venv, and inside it, that's how it looks like. So it has completed creating the virtual environment. We have different the lib folder, scripts folder, the gitignore, and the configuration folder that has .cfg. So we will clear our screen. To activate our environment, you can just type the path, which is venv scripts. The bin is for Linux machine, so scripts activate. So there's an activate dot, since we are using, we will switch to command prompt, and we can activate it while they are using the venv scripts and activate. So inside that folder we have the activate dot bat file, the activate for powershell.ps1. yeah, so you notice that we have something that wasn't there before. So we have, that is the venv, is our, it indicates that we are in an active environment, virtual environment. So we can try and list the packages And you'll notice that it will only be having the default packages that comes with Python. So you have pip, setup tools, and wheel. So the wheel is tied to what you call the cheese shop. You can Google about the cheese shop with regard to Python. So we have been able to list our packages, and now we are going to install one of the libraries. So we will install Django using pip install Django. Django is a web framework for Python. It is used in developing websites and full stack projects. So it is installing Django and its dependencies. So note that these packages will only be in this environment. So if we create a new environment elsewhere, it will have different libraries. So it has completed, and we can try and test the Django, or we can list first. So let's list the packages, and indeed we see we have Django 3.2.8 that has been installed. So we can also test the Django if it's working by, let's create a new project using the Django. So I've just typed the Django admin, and it gives us the list of all these commands. So we are going to start some project as a way of testing that our Django is working. So start Django admin start project, and we name the project my underscore project and a ladder dot so that it creates in the current directory. So if we go to navigate, we'll see that there are some files that have been created. And we can test also the working of Django using the py command and manage.py, which is a file that is in the folder. And it shows us the commands when you click enter. So you just clear the screen and py manage.py. A run server, so it's going to start a development server. As you can see, it has showed us some information and a URL. So indeed we have been able to install Django inside our virtual environment. So that is how you install the packages inside the virtual environment. We can clear the screen and to exit. So we've been able to create our virtual environment. Click share, like, and subscribe to my videos, and don't forget to click the bell icon for notifications. Thank you.